Hi, Danielle, I'm here with the Sacramento Association of Realtors with this month's Tech Tip. And this month we are talking about QR codes. And if you've never heard of a QR code, believe me, you're not alone. Perhaps you've seen one, it looks a lot like this. This is a basic QR code. Pretty much they all look the same. It's a two-dimensional barcode instead of just the single-dimensional ones that go straight across. Now, there's actually quite a bit to the barcodes. I've actually created this little document here, kind of give you a little tech behind the QR codes. So the blue areas here are actually versioning information. We have the red areas, which give the formatting information. Yellow areas are the timing codes, which you probably don't care too much about. The main thing that you'd care about is this middle area here, because that's the actual data. We also have the big squares, that is for the positioning, and we have the small box here that is the alignment. The nice thing about that is you could actually scan the barcode from any direction and it would still scan. Now, these are becoming more and more popular thanks to advances in smartphones. And for this tech tip, we thought we'd actually show you how you could create your own QR barcode. So the QR codes look pretty complicated, and you would think generating one would actually be complicated, but I assure you they are not. So when I go to create one, I just go to Google, I type in QR code generator, and pretty much any of the top 10 ones are great ones to work with. They all offer the service for free. This one offers quite a few different options depending on what you want to use. So if I want to create a QR code for a URL, I just type in the URL here. Do it for our main website and hit generate the code, and up pops the code, which you can then download, copy, and use wherever you want. Put on a flyer, the back of your business card. You can just put on, if you have a newsletter that you send out, put it in the newsletter. Another one I like is called QRStuff.com. This one offers even more options. If you wanted to say, link to a YouTube video, maybe for an open house that you have on your flyer, you just go to YouTube, take the URL code, copy, paste, and then the code should automatically generate off to the right here, which you could then print out, you could email, and you could also put on a lot of different options for hats, mugs, coffee mugs. So a lot of websites giving you a lot of different options for being able to create these codes. And I basically created two codes real fast in under a minute. So it's really easy to do. And the best part is these websites offer it for free. So QR codes offer a lot of possibilities, and people are coming up with new ways to use them all the time. I've created a couple quick examples to show how they might be beneficial to you. So if you have a flyer for a house that you're selling, you could actually have a QR code in the corner where if someone takes their smartphone, they could actually scan it, and it'll take them to a YouTube video showing them a virtual tour of the house. You may have seen these around town. These are being sent out by Google, where it's a decal that goes on the window that has a QR code. When scanned, it will actually give more information about the business, and people can read reviews, leave reviews. Another great benefit of QR codes is actually the business card, because on the back, you could have a QR code. When scanned, all the information is added right into the address book. So QR codes are becoming more mainstream, really easy to use, easy to create. Software is available for most of the major smartphones, and it's free. So I'd recommend at least looking into it. And thanks for watching, and stay tuned next month for next month's Tech Tip. Thanks.